Let's talk about how to place a stock buy order in 5 easy steps. So, are you thinking about buying stocks? Well, you should, because the stock market is making new all-time highs and there are tremendous opportunities in the market. So, time to buy some stocks, right? But there are a few things to consider. So, here's what you need to consider is, first of all, what stock should you buy? And then actually, how do you place an order? What is actually the difference between market orders, stop orders, and limit orders? And should you use day orders or GTC orders? And see, if you're new to trading, it can be hard to remember all of these details. And that's why I created this complete tutorial for beginners that explains everything you need to know about buying stocks online in 5 easy steps. So let's get started. Here are the 5 steps. And as you can see, step number one, is selecting an online stockbroker. When buying stocks, if you want to buy a stock, you must have an account with an online broker. If you already have a broker, you can skip ahead to the next steps. There will be timestamps in the description of the video, but if you need a broker or you don't know whether your broker is any good, let's talk about it for a moment. Now, the good news is it will only take you 15 minutes to open an account and you will be ready to trade within a day. Now, as you know, there are plenty of online brokers to choose from. The most popular online stock brokers in the US include, for example, Robinhood, super popular. We have TD Ameritrade. We have Interactive Brokers. We have Charles Schwab and many, many others. How do you choose the right broker? Well, here are a few things to consider. Number one, trading costs. Think about how much you plan to trade and compare some trading costs. You see, some brokers charge you $5 per trade. Yes, they still exist, while most others offer you commission-free trading. If you only place a few trades per year, this won't matter, right? But if you're planning to actively buy and sell stocks, you need to pay attention to these trading costs. But commissions are only one of the criteria that you should consider. You see, for me, it is also important that it is easy to use their platform. After all, you don't want to fumble around when placing a trade. And I want to have some great customer support, because when I have a problem, I want to be able to call somebody and talk to them. I do not want to write an email to support and wait for a day to receive an answer. And I also don't want to be in a long waiting line just to hear 156 times, "Your call is important to us. Please stay on the line until the next customer support specialist is available." You get the idea, right? Long story short, the brokers that I personally use are Tastyworks and Tradier. And what we will do today is, in order to place a trade, I will show you Tradier's platform. A few weeks ago, I did a video comparing different zero commission brokers, and I'll link to it in the description so that you can see exactly why I choose the brokers. That's enough about brokers. Let's move on to step number two. Step number two is research the stocks you want to buy. Let me show you how I pick the best stocks to trade. Now, again, if you already know what stock you want to buy, just skip ahead to the next section. Timestamps are in the description. But let me show you how I do it. When trading stocks, I use technical analysis. And I'm using 3 indicators that you see here at the bottom of the chart. So I use the RSI, I use the stochastics, and I use the MACD. And also, I am using my software, the PowerX Optimizer, to scan 14,000 stocks and ETFs every day to find the ones with the highest probability. Now, if you want to know how exactly I do this, I also have another video for you. I'll link to it in the description, in which I show you my trading routine in detail. But let's right now focus on placing a trade. So let's say I want to buy shares of Signet Jeweler. This is the chart that you see here on the screen. So it's SIG, Signet Jeweler. Here we go. So here's how to do it. Well, first of all, before we can do it, if we switch over here to the broker, the first thing that your broker wants to know is, what exactly do you want to trade? So we have to enter the symbol. So that's the easy part here. All we need to do is enter SIG, for example, or if you want to trade Apple, you would enter Apple. If you want to trade Tesla, you would enter Tesla. You get the idea, but let's stick with the example of SIG. So what do we want to buy? The side that we want to trade is buying. So that's all easy. But now the next question is, how many shares do we want to buy? So let's talk about this. for a moment. Because you see, most people don't know how to determine the amount of shares to buy. That's actually critical. It's absolutely crucial because if you buy too many or too few shares, your trades might turn out badly and cost you a lot of money. So let me show you how I do it. It's a simple two-step approach. So number one, we have to determine the risk per share. So you have to determine how much you want to risk per share. And this is also called a so-called stop loss. This stop loss is a stock price level at which you admit that you were wrong and now you will sell the stock at a loss. Keep in mind that losses are part of our business as traders, and the key is to keep your losses small. So let me show you how to do it. There are many, many ways to determine a stop loss, and here are two popular approaches. The first one is that you are using a support level. So you're looking at the chart, and I might zoom out a little bit so that you see a few more weeks, and you determine a support level. So in our example, we see that, for example, 60 is a pretty good support level. Wouldn't you agree? Like here, maybe even a little bit less, like 57.50, but right here, we have a pretty good support level. Because if you're buying the stock and it moves below 60, you were probably wrong and it's time to sell the stock. However, I personally believe that this here is way too much risk, because you would risk like $10 per share. So here's what I like to do. I like to use the so-called average daily range. Let me write this down. So this is the ADR, the average daily range, to support my stop loss. So the average daily range tells you how much a stock moves on average during the day. You can easily calculate it by subtracting the low of the day from the high. So high minus low, and then build a simple 7-day moving average around it. It's a very simple formula that you can put in there. Or if your software has the ATR, the average true range, that is fine too. In our example here for SIG, the ADR yesterday was $3.61. Now we want to give the stock enough room to move throughout the day, and that's why I like to use 1.5 times the ADR as a stop loss. Now in our example, 1.5 times $3.61 would be $5.42. So if we look at our entry signal here that the PowerX Optimizer gives us based on the indicators, and we want to buy to open at 71.03, now we need to calculate our stop loss. And our stop loss is 71.03 minus what we just calculated, the $5.42. So this means at 65.41, we would place a stop loss. So for me, that is a great stop loss level. Let's take a look at the chart and see where it would be. So we're talking about 65.41, somewhere around here. So, but wait, what does all of this have to do with the amount of shares that we want to buy? Well, that's where we need to go to step number two. And really, this is something that most traders get wrong. So this is why I'm spending quite a little bit of time on here. Anyhow, so number two, you want to calculate the number of shares. So as a rule of thumb, you should not risk more than 2% on your account on any given trade. So let's say you have a $10,000 account and you multiply this by 2%, that would be risking $200 on this trade. That is the maximum loss that you want to experience. So how exactly can you make sure you're not losing more? Well, this is by adjusting the number of shares that you buy. This is how you limit the risk. Well, and here's how we do it. We take the overall risk, which is the $200, and divide this by the stop loss amount. The stop loss amount was $5.42. And if we do this, we arrive at 36 and something, and we're taking 36 shares. So since we plan to exit the trade when the stock moves to 65, 61, somewhere around there, we would lose $5.42 per share. And if we take this times 36, so this would be exactly $195.12. Check my math. Anyhow, is this making sense? So let's jump to our trading platform and enter the information that we have thus far. So again, every broker is asking for the same information. And we already talked about, we have the stock SIG, we want to buy it, and the number of shares is 36. So Next, see, we're almost there, but we have to specify at what price we want to buy the stock. This is where right now we are on step number four. Let's just bring up the steps here again. So step number four is, okay, should you use a market stop or limit orders? So these are the orders that you can use. Let's actually jump back here onto our trading platform so that you see exactly what these are. So as you can see, there are four different orders: market, limit, stop, and stop limit. Let me explain each one as well as the pros and cons. Let's actually start here with a market order. When we choose, let me actually choose here a market order, because when I do this, here is what will happen. Market order. You see, the price disappears because a market order is an instruction to your broker or this trading platform to buy the stock at the asking price. So let's take a look at the asking price here of SIG. So right now, see up here, there's the bid and there's the ask. If you enter a market buy of 36 shares, your trade would immediately be executed at the current ask price. In this example, it would be at $70.87. So the advantage of this order, you get filled immediately and you're now the proud owner of 36 shares of Signet Jeweler if you want to trade this. Now, the disadvantage is that you had zero control over this trade price other than watching the markets and waiting for the right moment. So this is why I personally prefer a stop order. So let's talk about a stop order. A stop order is an order to buy or also sell a stock at the prevailing market price if the market price hits a specific level. And this level is called right here, either the stop price or also the trigger price. The most popular type here is just a simple stop order. This is often used as a stop loss order, which is triggered by a loss and then it will turn into a market order. But you can also use this order to enter a trade as a specified price. So let's say you want to buy, say, once the price moves above the high of the previous day to make sure that there's enough momentum to move this stock higher. Now, in our example, if we go back to the PowerX Optimizer, the PowerX Optimizer tells us exactly to buy it at $71.03. And this is 1 cent above the previous day's high. So here's what we would do. We would go to our trading platform, place a stop and actually specify the price, the stop price here of $71.03. So here is what will happen when you're using a stop order, right? It means that as soon as the stock price, which right now is at $72.82, as soon as it reaches 71.03, then buy 36 shares of SIG, Signet Jeweler, at the market price. Now, the advantage of using a stop order is that we don't have to be glued in front of our computer all day waiting for SIG to move up and hit our price. So we could go to the beach. However, the disadvantage of a stop order is that it is not guaranteed that our trade gets filled at the specified price. Because let's see what would happen if SIG would jump up, would gap up to, let's say, at $75 right here. In this case, we would automatically get filled at $75 since we are trading above our trigger price of $71.03. Making sense thus far? Okay, so how can we avoid getting filled at a much higher price? Well, this is where we go back and we could use a stop limit order. Now, a stop limit order is effectively a stop order that includes another price, not only the trigger price, this is the trigger price, but also a limit price, which defines the maximum price at which you're willing to buy the stock. So let me give you an example. Let's say we want to buy SIG once it's moving above 71.03, but we don't want to pay more than 71.10 for the stock. In this case, we would place a stop limit order at 71.10. So we specify two prices. The first is the trigger price, which says as soon as it moves above there, what is the maximum price that we want to pay for this? So this way, by placing a stop limit orders, we only get filled if SIG moves above 7102. So if it moves to 7103 or above, and we will get filled at 7110 or lower. So by using a stop limit order, we avoid getting filled at a price we don't want. For example, if it is gapping all the way up to 75. Now the disadvantage, if the stock rises above 71.3 and quickly jumps to 71.20, we might not get filled, but this is a very unlikely scenario. Now, in my experience, you're getting filled at the price you want with a stop limit order here 9 out of 10 times. And that's why I personally like to use stop limit orders for my entry. So let's quickly talk about the last order type. And the last order type that we have here is a simple limit order. A limit order only gives you one price, and this is the maximum price that you're willing to buy. For example, if you want to buy SAG only if it is trading below $70. So we take a look at the chart here and we say, yeah, you know what? Right now we say it's trading at $70.98. We only want to buy it if it is trading below $70. In this case, we can use a simple limit order, and we specify a price of $70. I like to use this type of order for my profit target. So let me give you just a very brief summary here of the order types before we move on to the last step of placing a stock buy order. First of all, for my entries, whenever I enter an order for my entries, I like to use stop limit orders when I'm placing stock trades, right? For my stop loss, which is exiting with the loss, I like to use a simple stop order. And for my profit target, for a profit taking order, this is where I would use a limit order. So typically I never use a market order. So we talked about this, don't like this one, since it doesn't give me any control about the execution of the trade. This making sense thus far? Okay, if so, click on like. And then let's talk about the last step, the duration of the order. And there's day orders, GTC or GTD orders. These are three different durations when placing a buy stop order. So the last thing that we need to specify is actually right here. As you can see, day or GTC is here the standard order. So what does this mean? Well, if you specify an order as a day order, the order will be executed today during market hours, or it expires automatically at the end of the day. As an example, we would place a stop order here. Let's go back here and let's just actually place a stop limit order at 71.10. We specify it as a day order, so it will get filled if the price today moves above 7103. And if it doesn't, then the order is automatically canceled after the markets close. And I like to use this, the day order, for my entries, because this way I know that I'm getting filled today, or I can look at the stock again tomorrow and decide if I still want to buy it. Now let's talk about another one. This is the GTC order. Now GTC stands for good till canceled. Here's what that means. When you set an order as a GTC, it means that this order will stay in effect until it's either filled or you change or cancel your order, because you can cancel an order at any time. So this order is perfect for exits. So these are the stop loss orders and profit taking orders. Because when using a GTC order, it will remain active until the stop loss or profit target is hit, or until you cancel it manually. So let's just briefly talk about the last order that we have here. The last order type is GTD, and this stands for good till date. And when you specify GTD order, it means that the order will stay in effect until either the expiration date or until it's filled or until you change or cancel the order. So this type of order is useful if you decide to buy a stock for a certain price, but only if you get filled for this week. As an example, if you would place an order to buy SIG here at a price of 71.03 stop GTD until Friday, in this case, you would either get filled if SIG moves above 71.03 before Friday, or the order is automatically canceled. Well, these are basically the five steps. So let's just briefly recap here. As you can see, there are a few things that you need to pay attention to when placing an order to buy a stock, but it's really not that complicated. I recommend that you practice it on a simulator first to get familiar with the different order types. Also, yeah, limit orders, day orders, GTC orders. And hey, if you would like to know how I personally trade these crazy markets, then here are two videos for you, hopefully popping up right now. One of them is explaining the Power X strategy, and the other one is explaining the wheel strategy in detail. Take a look at these and I will see you in the next video. So click on one of these videos right now.